Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2005 South Korean war film called Welcome to Dongmak Gol, also known as Battleground 625. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The movie begins with an American Navy pilot, Neil Smith, struggling to maneuver his plane when a massive storm of butterflies interrupts his flying. The plane crashes into a remote and mountainous part of Korea, as it gives Neil a bumpy and dangerous ride. A platoon of North Korean soldiers passes through the rocky part of the mountains, as soldiers are carrying their comrades who are bloody and have injuries. As one of the soldiers asks the chief commander, Soo Hwa, to leave their comrades, which hinders them to move faster, the two argue whether they should continue or not. The tension rises between the two when suddenly, South Korean troops ambush the unit, showering them with bullets and almost killing everyone. Running from opposite directions to hide and save their lives, the soldiers go separate ways. Moon Sang-song, a South Korean soldier, halts and tries to rest on the foot of a tree to eat. While he is eating, he sees a comrade, Yoon Chul, from a different team pointing his gun on his chin, as if preparing to shoot himself. Despite his fear to face him, he tries to stop him from his indecisive decision. Instead, the man points his gun near Moon Sang-song's head when he notices that he's from the enemy's troop. Fortunately, the man spares his life, leaving him immediately. Meanwhile, four North Korean soldiers survive the ambush. However, they choose to trail the track along a dangerous mountain cliff to go back alive in Pyongyang. One by one, the soldier tries to cross the trail, but one of them fails to survive. As Soo Hwa orders Young Hee and Taek Gi to proceed with their journey, they decide to stop for a while and rest. While the three soldiers try to sleep, a dumb girl, Yo Il, who lives in Dongmak Gol, sees them. Yo Il asks the three soldiers to leave the place, as they are currently staying on Snake Rock. When a snake falls on Young Hee's shoulder, they shoot the area to kill what's coming. However, they ran out of bullets, but nothing came out. Soo Hwa is outrageous with the impulsive move, and Yo Il leaves. Moon Sang-song chases Yoon Chul. The two soldiers proceed walking in the mountainous area when they find a villager, Dal Soo, who is collecting some herbal plants. The villager leads them towards Dongmak Gol, hiking their way to find the remote village. Upon arrival, Moon Sang-song and Yoon Chul could not believe their eyes that a community existed in the mountains. The villagers see Smith, who has a lot of injuries from the plane crash. They bring him to their village to treat his wounds. As the people observe the stranger's unconscious body, moments later, Smith wakes up. One of the villagers, Teacher Kim, tries to communicate with him through the Korean English primer given by Smith. Unfortunately, due to the language barrier, Teacher Kim cannot grasp Smith's response when he starts to complain, and the words he uses are not included in the guide. While Teacher Kim interrogates Smith, a villager interrupts him when a rushing member reports that Dal Soo brings strangers to their village. The villagers immediately check the situation as Teacher Kim decides to leave Smith all by himself when he can no longer understand the primer. The villagers and the village chief welcome Moon Sang-song and Yoon Chul. As the chief invites them to eat, they lead the two where they left Smith. Yoon Chul points his gun to Smith upon seeing him, but when he realizes that he is from the UN, he brings his gun down. Smith, on the other hand, thinks that these men are sent to find him. The people strangely look at Smith's outburst, as he continuously speaks the alien language. Soo Hwa, Young Hee, and Taek Gi capture Yo Il and a child, Dong Gu, to lead them in the mountains. When they see Teacher Kim, who tries to practice and understand the primer, the three soldiers hide. Yo Il walks in Teacher Kim's direction to find out who he is, and the soldiers get this opportunity to capture him. Yo Il, Teacher Kim, and the children assist Soo Hwa, Young Hee, and Taek Gi towards their village. Moon Sang-song and the villagers were happily chit-chatting when Teacher Kim and the North Korean soldiers arrived. Upon seeing each other, the two opposing troops point their guns and threaten the life of each other. The villagers are held as captives, as they are entirely confused with the happenings, unaware of the coming danger and the existence of the modern technologies used for warfare devices. Soo Hwa deceives Moon Sang-song and Yoon Chul when he tries to drop his gun. With quick reflexes, he grabs a grenade. Young Hee and Taek Gi follow to warn the villagers and the two soldiers from South Korea. As the night passes, the soldiers are just pointing their guns at each other, the captives in the middle, and no one tries to surrender from their enemy. Until the rain starts to pour, the villagers decide to go on their shelter, and the soldiers remain on their stance. Suddenly, Yo Il intervenes in their little show. He wipes off Taek Gi's face using her socks, and quickly removes the grenade's lock. Thinking that it is a ring, Yo Il escapes, enjoying what she retrieved from his hands. The soldiers panic, as they know that an explosion will occur, but the villagers are merely clueless with their reactions. Till the rain stopped pouring, and the scorching sun took over, the soldiers did not leave their place. Tired of their sleepless night, Tekki drops his grenade, and it rolls down on the ground. Upon realization, Su Hua orders them to take cover, and secure themselves from the explosion. Yun Chul dives on the grenade, and covers it with his body, but nothing happens seconds later. Yun Chul mocks the North Korean soldiers when he thought that the bomb is a dud. He throws the explosive device in the village storage room. The bomb explodes, and transforms the collected corns into popcorns. The popcorn showers the Dongmakgal village, and the villagers are extremely amazed at the scenario. As the popcorn show continues, one by one, the soldiers faint due to their exhaustion. When the soldiers rise, the feud continues. But the village chief intervenes and tells Yun Chul and Moon San Song that Su Hua promises to stop their impulsive moves within the vicinity of the village. As the chief invites them to eat, they can hear the rants and complaints of the villagers about the explosion of their food storage room. Guilt is eating their system, the soldier raises the truce for a while, and decides to help the villagers harvest potatoes in the fields. The encounters between the soldiers are lighter than before, just an exchange of insulting and degrading remarks. Yun Chul informs Su Hua's group that the Allied forces have already landed in Incheon Airport. From his speculations, the forces have already conquered Pyongyang. From their headquarters, the US Navy discusses the missing transport planes after they are lost in their expedition. However, the geographical information hinders them from further investigation. That's why they have to secure the parameters first before the search takes over. Tekki sees Yo Il admiring the grenade's metal ring-like lock. As she gazes her eyes in his direction, he chooses to walk out as he is mesmerized by her beauty. Going in the opposite direction, Tekki sees Yun Chul and Moon San Song, and hits them with below-the-belt hit remarks. Yun Chul is angered by Tekki's words, as he tries to punch him and teaches him a lesson. Su Hua meddles with Yun Chul's outburst. He reminds him of the bloodless encounters in the village, a ceasefire for the sake of the villagers. Clouded by rage, Yun Chul punches Su Hua on his face, the latter fights back. Their comrades try to stop them as the villagers are now watching the punching session. Dong Gu sees Smith, who tries to communicate in his headquarters. Smith ignores Dong Gu, and proceeds to contact his comrades, and informs them about Sparrow A1. One of his comrades hears the message, but the connection is now lost. Moon San Song complains that it is North Korea's fault why they are stuck in an isolated place. Tekki argues that South Korean soldiers who summoned the presence of the United States caused this feud between their parties. But Su Hua answers Tekki, and confirms that the North first invaded the South. Suddenly, the presence of a wild boar who is troubling the village appears. The soldier and villagers end up helping each other, to drag the wild boar down. The bravery to save their enemy, and the death of the animal is a room for celebration. To their disappointment, the villager buries the wild boar. Moon San Song and Yun Chul sneak out to dig the animal so they could eat it. Flabbergasted by what they have witnessed, the three North Korean soldiers are already roasting and eating the animal. Yun Chul decides to leave, but Moon San Song stops him so they could sit over and eat. Unexpectedly, Smith also tries to sneak out so he could eat the animal. The soldiers devour the meat of the wild boar with enthusiasm, and the tension between them starts to drop when they eat together. The unplanned meal gives them a temporary ceasefire and enjoyment. The US Navy tries to decode Smith's previous last radio transmission. With a reason to continue the search, the Allied commander's orders to continue the mission, regardless of the civilian casualty. From their speculations, Smith is a prisoner in the mountain areas, and they must prepare a rescue team to recover him. Smith teaches the soldiers and the villagers to play American football. While these people play, Smith sees Dong Gu holding an army recorder. Dong Gu leads Smith to the remnants of a plane that has crashed. The game continues, but the chief villager's mother calls Hyung Chul's attention. Arriving at her place, Hyung Chul receives a small boat hay-like ride from her. He rides the small boat, and slides down through the grassy slope of the mountain. When he no longer controls his vessel, Hyung Chul falls, and lies down on the grassland. Hyung Chul admires the bluish-white clouds when floods of memories from the war fill his mind. The trauma scarred his mind, as the experiences from the battle still haunt his memories wherever they go. As he closes his eyes, he savors the tragic memory of the civilian casualties during the battle. Meanwhile, Yo Il observes Hyung Chul, who seems to be sleeping on the grass. Leaving him at peace, she tries to run, but falls from the grass. Several army trucks are arriving. The commander orders his team to rescue Smith, and after 24 hours, they must evacuate, and stop bombing their location. Wishing a successful mission, he dismisses the platoon to proceed. Techie admires Yoel, who enjoys herself in the pouring rain. Saddened by their departure once they finished rebuilding the storage room, he asks Soo-hwa about their plans. When Yoel removes her cloth foot cover, Techie rushes towards her to give her his handkerchief. The camaraderie between the people and soldiers shows when they help and eat together. The Dongmak Gul village celebrates its harvest festival. Dancing and singing, just purely enjoying their little party. While the people enjoy their celebration, Hyung Chul and Soo-hwa exchange conversations about their life after this Dongmak Gul journey. Yoon Chul then reveals that a firing squad is prepared for him once he gets back. Commander Inselmo leads the team to use aerial transport to invade the area. While the soldiers ride their parachute, a torrent of butterflies interrupts their mission. As they receive severe casualties, only 5 soldiers survived. While the villagers are enthusiastic about their celebration, Dong-gu and the soldiers witness the arrival of the US troops. The rescue team assumes that they have arrived at the enemy's base. The rescuers gatecrash the festival and hold the villagers captive. Commander Inselmo hits the villagers with the base of his gun, blabbering of not joking around in the situation. Yoel suddenly intervenes and tries playing with the soldiers. The latter tries to kill her. Before he could even touch Yoel, Taekgi stops the soldier, saying that she is crazy. Upon hearing his accent, the soldier recognizes that he may be from the north. The villagers try to conceal Taekgi's identity by claiming that he is their son. The village chief speaks up for his little community, but the soldier hits him. This ignites the burning fire inside Hyung Chul as he breaks the wooden stick and stabs it to the soldier's neck. This movement angers the rescue team. They start to become violent, but Soo-hwa and his comrades fought back. One soldier survives and hides from the crowd. When he gets the chance, he grabs his knife and captures one of the villagers as his hostage. Hyung Chul prepares to save the villager by pointing the gun at the enemy's head, but Smith arrives and smacks his head. Seconds later, one of the villagers attends to Yoel, who is dying on the ground. With one last breath, she passes away. The last man from the rescue team is in their custody. As he wakes up, Soo-hwa interrogates him when Moon San-song retrieves a plan on his army jacket. The man reveals that the place will be bombed after some time, making them all die. Later on, he discovers that Smith is living with the villagers. Smith, together with the North and South Korean soldiers, plans to create a decoy to divert the attention of the rescuers from bombing Dongmak Gul. Despite the hesitations from Young-hee and Moon San-song, Hyung Chul and Soo-hwa encourage them to participate in their plan. As they retrieve materials from the plane that has crashed nearby, Soo-hwa entrusts this mission to Hyung Chul. The soldiers, the translator, and Smith bid their goodbye to the villagers of Dongmak Gul. The villagers are saddened by the departure of these strangers who have become their family. Before they leave, Smith leaves the hay-like ball to Dong-gu, a remembrance from him. And one of the villagers offers a thick cover in case they need it. Wearing their thick jackets, the Korean soldier decides to send Smith and the translator back to their headquarters to control and stop the coming of more bombers. Before they part ways, Smith hands his watch to wish the soldiers luck to be successful on their mission. The North-South Korean soldiers played like the allies. Hyung Chul serves as the commander and orders his men to position and arranges their setup. They set their decoy in the snowy mountains and craft it like a village so the attackers will mistake their base as the Dongmak Gul. Nighttime arrives, and the soldiers hear the arrival of fighter jets within the mountains. Running to prepare their stunt, they prepare their guns and wait it until the bomber is on their range. Young-hee asks Moon San-song to sing the song he utters during the festival. Seconds later, the American bombers arrive. When it was the right time to attack, they shot them with bullets to catch their attention. However, bullets are not enough, as Soo-hwa immediately fires the bazooka upwards. The American bombers take the hint from the warning shot given by the enemies. The chase continues between the Americans and Koreans. The war has begun. Bullets after bullets. Bombs after bombs. The Koreans struggled to survive until they lost Moon San-song and Young-hee to the initial encounter. In no time, the American bombers plan to launch a bunch of bombs to secure the victory in the area. Taekgi, Hyung Chul, and Soo-hwa look up at the sky and watches the released bombs falling from above. They knew that they successfully executed their plan. They saved the villagers, and Dongmak Gul, smiling, he welcomed the cruelty of the explosions. The movie ends with a distant bomb explosion from the mountains. Smith breaks down into tears when he realizes that the Korean soldiers sacrificed their lives to save Dongmak Gul. From the decoy base, butterflies appear and join the fluttering swarms from above. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.
Thank you.